Coffee or tea impacting how much algae we see blooming in the waterways of Southwest Florida.
NBC2's Rachel Whalen spoke with researchers from the University of Florida about this new study.
Our bodies can't break down the Splenda we use to sweeten our coffee, so it often ends up in our waterways. That's why scientists are studying how it affects our environment, specifically the blue-green algae in your backyard.
You can find these little yellow packets in just about every diner across America. But there's a lot we don't know when it comes to artificial sweeteners and the way they affect our environment.
We're a population that is starting to really look at those as weight loss options, and that's been an exponential increase over the past couple decades.
That's why Amelia Westmoreland led a study with the University of Florida to see if sucralose, the ingredient in artificial sweeteners, can impact blue-green algae.
It wasn't a measurement of the sucralose that was already present, but rather we were going in and dosing it in a controlled environment to see what happened then.
She says the results were surprising. In brackish water environments, high levels of sweetener decreased blue-green algae populations. But in fresh water, it did the opposite.
A hypothesis that we had was that it might be because they viewed this almost as a nutrient, so they were treating it as a little bit of a help.
I think that's pretty crazy. It's something that we're drinking and eating on a daily basis.
Splenda the sugar? Okay, one, I don't use it, so I'm all natural. So I'm a sugar girl all the way, but I believe any chemical, it's probably a chemical, I guess, I don't even know, is going to affect our environment. So I believe that.
Is this a big enough concern that people should watch how much Splenda they intake?
I personally tried to consume a little bit less zero-calorie sweeteners just because I know it's not the most natural choice. But that's more of a human and anthropological concept than it is us warning against the environment. So based on the study, I would say there's a lot more questions and a lot more directions we could look into for how we might need to adjust if we need to as a community.
Now Amelia is hoping other scientists pick up her study and expand it.
I think that there are quite a few directions that additional scientists could take this to see how far we could go with it. As I said before, what we found was actually a lot of questions to the answers that we ended up with.
I'm reporting in downtown Fort Myers, Rachel Whalen, NBC2.